Welcome to this week's news update on the construction industry in Africa, brought to you by Construction Review. In today's news, Morocco launches the construction of 70 megawatt PV plant. South Africa, Unit 5 of Medupi Power Station attains commercial operation status. KenGen to commence the construction of oil carrier 5 plant in Kenya. Actis to build wind farm in Egypt. And South Africa unveils first locomotive to be manufactured in Africa. Welcome, I'm Yvonne Andiva. We begin this week's news in Morocco, where King Mohammed V has launched the building of a 70 megawatt Nur Kwazaste 5 PV plant. This fourth stage of the scheme is the PV portion of the 580 megawatt solar power station, OSPS, a CSP PV solar power complex situated in the Drat Tafilalet region, central Morocco. The complex involves the 160 megawatt Nur 1 CSP power station, which was finished in February 2016, and the Nur 2 CSP and Nur 3 CSP, which are presently under development and will have a capacity of 200 megawatts and 150 megawatts respectively. According to the Moroccan government, the Nur 2 CSP and Nur 3 CSP plants have reached a completion rate of 76% and 74%. In November, the Moroccan Agency for Solar Energy, MASEN, signed a 20-year power purchase agreement with Aqua Power for the development of the three projects. Saudi Arabia's Aqua Power was nominated after an international tender to develop, construct and run the three plants under a build, operate, own and transfer scheme. Aqua Power signed on the world's biggest EPC company, Sterling and Wilson, to build the installation in late November. And now in South Africa, South African state-owned utility Eskom has announced that Unit 5 at its Medupi Power Station project in Lephalale, Limpopo, has finally achieved commercial operation status. Operating ahead of plan, the utility said that the unit was formally confirmed commercial after the completion of control performance and the 72-hour dependability tests, putting all performance warranties to effect. With a production of 800 megawatts going to the national grid, Unit 5 joined its sister Unit 6, which has been adding to the balancing of electricity supply and demand since 23rd August 2015. MED is a dry-cooled coal-fired power station, and when completed, the power station is to have 6 boilers, each powering an 800 megawatt turbine, producing 4,800 megawatts of power. Once completed, Medupi Power Station will be the fourth largest coal-fired plant and the largest dry-cooled power station in the world. And now over to Egypt. Actis Egypt's director, Sharif Al-Holi, has confirmed that the firm has handed in all the necessary paperwork to the Ministry of Electricity and is now in talks with the government to sign the last contract to establish a wind farm in Egypt in the second quarter of this year. The full cost of this farm is appraised at $350 million. Lekala Power has signed a memorandum of understanding with the Ministry of Electricity 2 years ago to put up a wind farm. Actis, a developing markets investor, owns 60% of Lekala Power. The remaining 40% is owned by the solar and wind energy developer Mainstream. Mr. El-Holi said that Lekala Power is set to put up a wind farm in the Gulf of Suez area with a capacity of 250 megawatts. He added that the project will be financed by Actis, a number of local and foreign banks. Actis has three direct investment funds in Africa, namely Actis Energy 3, Actis 4, and Actis Africa 4. And now over to Kenya. Kenya's power producer, KenGen, is set to begin the building of the Olkaria 5 140 megawatt plant by June this year after a postponement of more than a year. The postponement was due to a drawn-out procedure of enlisting a contractor and obtaining resources for the project. The plant, which is estimated to cost more than $530 million, will upsurge electricity available from geothermal and further stabilize power supply in the nation when complete in 2019. Although Kenya has considerably grown the energy generation mix, it is still greatly dependent on hydroelectricity and therefore vulnerable to shocks whenever there is a lengthy dry spell. Energy Principal Secretary, Mr. Joseph Njoroge, said all is now in place and construction will commence in June. The plant will be ready to begin feeding the national electricity grid by 2019. He spoke in Nairobi on the sidelines of a renewable energy conference. KenGen owns 31 power generating plants with a joint installed capacity of 1,337 megawatts from varied generation approaches, as well as hydro, thermal, geothermal, and wind technologies. And again, in South Africa, Transnet, which is South Africa's rail company, recently unveiled the first locomotive to be designed, engineered, and manufactured in Africa, the Trans-Africa Locomotive. Transnet Chief Executive Officer Siyabonga Gama confirmed the news and said that the new locomotive, which will be assembled at the company's production facility east of Pretoria, symbolized a crucial and vital step in its strategy of becoming a leading manufacturer and supplier of rolling stock in Africa. The locomotive is appropriate for use on branch lines and in the yard for shunting, while also being able to travel on all rail tracks originally designed to carry light axle loads. The Trans-Africa locomotive, which is diesel-powered, is additionally applicable for aged railway lines that operate on the Cape gauge system, while offering a cost-effective solution for the majority of the continent's railway lines that are currently unused. Transnet is the largest and most crucial part of the freight logistic chain that delivers goods across South Africa. That's all we had for you this week. Please subscribe on our YouTube channel and enjoy weekly updates as they happen. You can also visit our website on www.constructionreviewonline for more construction news in Africa. Thank you for watching. I'm Yvonne Adima. We'll be right back.